So what are we doing?
We are talking about the, you know, all these kids graduating high school and college, they're not going to get to go to graduation, right?
They're not, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So we thought maybe we could offer some books that people might want to gift to their graduating...
Because they should still get presents.
They get presents. We got to celebrate
their accomplishments.
Yeah, because
they're graduating. Even if they don't get to wear the cap and gown and march across the stage, they get presents.
And who is more qualified to offer these sorts of ideas than someone who took 8 years to get through undergraduate education?
And someone who never got through undergraduate education.
Yes.
Yeah. So we know what we're talking about. You know?
So let's think about what do people need to get through their upcoming years. I'm going to start with this one, Steve.
Okay, you start with that.
This is called Wilmington's Lie, The Murderous Coup of 1898 and the Rise of White Supremacy. I don't, you know, for a 19th century event, I'm not sure there's a more significant 20th century historical event for North Carolina. This documents the white riot that overthrew the duly elected government of Wilmington in 1898. And it just spells out the horrors of white supremacy, how it lingered through the 20th, and may I say the 21st century. And it's just, you can't live in North Carolina without knowing this history. You might have missed this history in your school. I'm just saying, a lot of schools still ignore this super important event. So, if you want to expand your education, Wilmington's Lie. What do you got?
I got something equally inspiring. Naomi Klein's The Shock Doctrine, which is a really fascinating book. You learn a lot about global economics. You learn about how governments work, especially first world governments in third world countries. And it's pretty frightening. But it's things you need to know, you know? We're trying to kind of give you some things you need to know as you enter the world. And both Brian and I know that, you know, education only gives you, like, standard education only gives you just a little view of things. So
we want you to graduate from the school of life.
The school of life.
Without
dishonor. We're talking about the school of life here. Naomi Klein's The Shock Doctrine. Great thing.
Okay. When, eventually, I did graduate from undergraduate college, I said, you know, now what do I do with your life? Like,
right.
How do you be of use was the thing I kept wanting to know. And this book gave me a roadmap about how to be useful in the world. This is called The Country Between Us by Carolyn Forché. It's a collection of poems, and it largely documents her trip to Nicaragua and El Salvador in the 1980s. And it's a frightful book, you know, that is a...
The phone's ringing, but we can ignore it. Yeah.
You know, and it just is her first stab at a poetry of witness, that it is your obligation as a writer, as a poet, to get to the places that need exposure and to write about them. So that gave me a blueprint, a way to think about what I can do. If I want to be a writer, what am I going to write about? You know, I'm kind of boring myself, but the world is not. So go find things that need to be explored, exposed, and write about them. Carolyn Forché.
And that's a good segue into Laurie Stone's book, which I think kind of approaches things in a bit of the same way. Even though we're kind of personally involved in the publication of Laurie's book, I really like it because, A, it gave me a kind of broader history of feminism over the last 30 years, kind of a ground level, very personal sense of that. And B, just because I like the way Laurie thinks, and I like the way that she puts things together. And there's always a sense in this book that you are thinking with her, or that you're thinking together. And I really appreciate that in Everything is Personal, Notes on Now, which is sort of a memoir, sort of an essay, sort of Facebook post. It's Laurie Stone all over the place, and that's a thing you will enjoy.
All right, speaking of things you enjoy.
Yes! We're moving on to enjoyment now. It's pretty exciting.
How about sex?
Yay!
I've heard good stories about sex. This book is called The Ethical Slut. And, you know, especially if you're graduating high school and moving into college, you're sort of opening up into a freer world.
One would hope.
You're out from under the rule of your evil parents. And this book is, a guide to exploring your sexuality, to finding a way to acknowledge your sexuality, to think about having sex neither makes you good nor bad. It's something you might like to do without any moral consequence, right? Slut is not gendered here. You know, we're not talking about women, we're talking about people. So if you want to have sex, you can. You can do it morally, ethically, safely. And this gives you lots of ways to think about that, and to think about polyamory even.
That's dangerous.
Whoa! I don't know. I think you'd do well to give your child this book. They will not accept it from a parent. Find an aunt or an uncle to give that to them.
Or just leave it somewhere, yes. Like they're not supposed to find it.
That's the best.
Yeah, something like that. And last but not least, we have Roberto Bolaño's novel, The Savage Detectives. Takes place in Mexico. I don't even remember when this takes place.
Boy, yeah.
Probably the 70s, I guess.
Yeah.
This is just one of my favorite novels of all time. It has to do with all these people who are like in this place where they don't quite know what they want to do. They know they want to do something important. They want to do something artistic. They talk about it forever. They drink a lot. They, you know, have sex a lot. Ethical, I would hope. And it just has this wonderful, magical, and as soon as I say magical, I wish I hadn't. But it is. It has this kind of magical sense of what it's like to be in this place where everything is anticipation, and everything is like potential, and everything is possible, but then not quite, maybe. And it's just a really, really great book. And anything by Bolaño is worth looking out for. But The Savage Detectives is really great.
Brilliant. And my favorite book of his.
Yeah. Yeah, so, absolutely. Yeah. Mine too. So, you know, I mean, you can get the, you know, commencement speeches by various people.
Given them. So
There's one by Kurt Vonnegut. There's one by John Waters. There's lots of inspiration. Brian and I tend to shy away from inspiration. I'm not even sure we believe in inspiration.
Well, it's not our job. How about
that? Yeah, okay, good. That's a good thing.
Yeah. Something you find on your own, right?
Yes. Find your own damn inspiration out there. But these are things that have sort of inspired us. So there you go. Move your tassel over and venture out into the world.
Into the school of life.
Yes.